For question number 154, the correct option is option number 2. And to arrive there, we shall make use of a shortcut. You see, they have referred to a hypothetical change in the mass of the sun and gravitational constant. And because of that change, if you look at the different options given, they have referred to various terrestrial events. Terrestrial events means events happening on or near the Earth's surface. In options 1, 3, and 4, they refer to some consequent change in the situation or in the event, but only in the option number 2 they are telling, in spite of change in sun's mass or gravitational constant, there is no change in the value of free fall acceleration g. So that option number 2, the suspect option, and we shall investigate that first. Now, recalling in step number 1, the formula for free fall acceleration g on the Earth's surface, g is given by capital G into me divided by re square. In this formula, capital G is gravitational constant, me is the mass of the Earth, re is the radius of the Earth. So in this formula, nowhere the mass of sun is coming. So if you make the mass of sun 10 times smaller, there is no effect of that on the free fall acceleration on the Earth's surface. But if the mass of the Earth and the radius of the Earth, they are kept constant without any change, you can see that this formula implies the value of free fall acceleration g varying directly as gravitational constant. And therefore, if gravitational constant is made 10 times larger, the value of g should also go up by 10 times, which really contradicts this option number 2 statement that g on the Earth will not change. So that is the incorrect statement. And for us, option number 2 is the correct option.